So, not represented. Shakir and Kashalena, but their details will be on our website. So, just, we're going to keep this quick, I think it's pretty quick. Could you just tell us why you'd be a good member of our delegation and how you'd represent Buck students when you arrive at the National Conference?
I think, as I mentioned about to you already, I would like to trust in. I think being involved in gives me the ability to know what Dutch students want. And attending the conference, and obviously Joe's president, and possibly Sarah, so probably a female delegate, would be an honour, because I would like to speak for Dutch and boys, whether they want to get involved in like national, which the national student movement or not. Whether they want to get involved in acting or just observe it, whether, I mean, there's issues at the moment, like if the government makes it illegal or criminal offence not to pay people, that's something that first I think shouldn't be done. And if the students but also agree with that, that's something that we can, you know, maybe get involved in it. If not, we can just go on and observe, like, historically, Bucks haven't got involved in national student issues, but if they want to, then we have to take that forward and make that happen. So.
We're looking a bit thin on numbers, but as you already know, I'm Sarah Baker. Woo! I'm not going to tell you about why I should be elected, because being a representative means we're representing everyone's views. So it isn't just about me, it's about what we want to bring forward and how I can best represent us on a national level. So I could go on and say I'd be good for this reason, but I think we both agree it's about what everyone else needs to be voiced, not what we want.
That's great. We've just got one question. If you were to propose one motion for NUS conference to consider from the main stage in a few weeks' time, whenever it is, what would it be? What would you ask the NUS to consider?
It's probably something they're already considering. Big issue that hopefully they're already taking seriously, but again, I would say that it's the government's idea to make it a criminal offence not to pay a student back up to 30 years. I mean, that's quite a big issue in my mind. I mean, if we have one in this group at 70 years old and we're getting sent to prison because we haven't paid a student loan back because we haven't made enough money or got a degree job, which we hopefully all have, I just think 30 years is a long time. If you have to pay it back by then, you know, you shouldn't be prosecuted for it because you haven't really got the job that you wanted. So yeah, that's something I hope they're already addressing and make sure they are.
As Ben raised, that's a very broad issue, but the main thing I'd like to target is also part of my presidential manifesto, is how we can make more allowances within the university environment, which six golden schools already do make, in how to make things more LGBT friendly. So the importance of having gender neutral toilets in ways that we can make life more inclusive for everyone, because say for example, I might be gender neutral and I might not be using the men's or the female's toilets. Like, this should be implemented and I should be able to use the toilet without having to think about, oh, people might think this about me.
Any questions from the floor? Anything? No, do you have anything else to add? Anything else you'd like to say? Absolutely nothing. All right, well, thanks very much.